Hi everybody, beautiful day here in central Kentucky. So I thought I'd take an hour and run a little switching operation on my layout like I told you I'd do last week. So we're actually catching the train. If you remember from my other video, that's the big Sandy River where the bridge is. In West Virginia, we're just catching the train as it rolls into the Hagen's Yard in eastern Kentucky. Just a caboose hop from Williamson. Okay, we dropped the caboose off. Next to the empties we're going to pick up. Now we're going to back down and grab the empties. Tried to get the caboose fairly close to the empties, save the brake one a little bit of walking. Okay, we got the empties. Now we're gonna pull up, throw the switch, then back onto the caboose. As you can see, Ollie, the railroad cat, is helping me out today. I wish he was a little bit more useful. He does do a pretty good job of catching mice and moles and things like that though, so he's just not much help running the trains. Okay, now we're going to back down, pick up the caboose. I am running track power today. I haven't converted this engine yet. So I did clean the track with the drywall sander. It's not doing too bad, considering I only have one set of feeder wires for the whole railroad. It's doing pretty good. Okay, we've done the air test, so we're ready to head out on the branch. I will spare you running the laps that I usually run, since I have a small railroad. I will have to stop after we get onto the main line and throw the switch after the caboose clears it. It's gonna be a little bit of dirty track right there. Okay, I ran on ahead so I could get the train exiting the tunnel. Still a slow order in place. I had a landslide here a couple months ago. I haven't completely fixed all the track yet. I said this is track power. I haven't, it doesn't have sound in this engine yet. Hope to rectify that sometime pretty soon. Okay, train has arrived at the coal mine. So we're gonna have to pull up past the switch. But we'll drop the caboose off before it reaches the switch so the brakeman can talk to the operator and make sure we're good to go. Climbed up on the side of a hill so I could get a little bit better view of the switching operation. We're going to back in and pull the three loads, and then we'll place them with the three empties.
pull those out of the caboose. We pulled the train forward to where the switch. Now we're backing the empties into the tipple.
Notice a wasp flying around. I think they're trying to build a nest in my tipple, so I have to be careful.
The brakes are pumped up. We're heading to Truett,
where the sawmill is,
and that's where we'll do the runaround.
It's not really, don't really want to push the caboose several miles, so we'll do a runaround to Truett.
I'm actually going to stop short of the switch with the caboose, drop it there so I can run around with the engine, pick it up, and tack it on to the end of the train. Drop the caboose. So now we're going to come around and then I'll drop the cars on the siding to run around everything. Sawmill got served yesterday, so it doesn't need switching today. Running around the train. Picking up the caboose. Putting the caboose on the back of the train. Train is assembled. We're gonna head back to the yard. pulling into the yard. Running around the train so we can put the loads
in the loads tracks. They can be picked up tonight
when the local freight drops off the empties. Spotting the loads on the load track. Crew runs around the caboose again. Now they're gonna tie down, go to lunch, and then head back across the Big Sandy River to another branch line to switch out there before heading back to Williamson to call it a shift. Hope you enjoyed this. Had a lot of teething pains doing this. Just need to level the track and everything, which I edited out. But anyhow, hope you enjoyed it. Talk to you later. Stay safe.